Gene expression is a fundamental life process providing a bridge between information encoded within a gene and a final functional gene product such as a protein. The process of gene expression is used by all known life such as eukaryotes, prokaryotes, and even viruses to generate the macromolecular machinery for life. The process of gene expression is summarized in the central dogma proposed by Francis Crick. The central dogma of molecular biology explains the flow of genetic information within a biological system. It states the one-way flow of information from DNA to RNA and from RNA to protein. The information contained in the section of DNA is copied in the form of a newly assembled piece of mRNA. This process is called transcription. Enzymes facilitating this process includes RNA polymerase and transcriptional factors. The information present in DNA is used by ribosomes to synthesize a specific protein. This process is called translation. In retroviruses, the transfer of information is reversed. Here, information is transferred from RNA to DNA by the help of an enzyme called reverse transcriptase. So the process is called reverse transcription. Transcription. It is the first step in gene expression. It occurs in the cytoplasm of prokaryotes and nucleoplasm of eukaryotes. Requirements. RNA polymerase is an enzyme that synthesizes RNA from a DNA template. It opens the double-stranded DNA at specific site so that one strand of the exposed DNA can be used as a template for the synthesis of RNA. It always builds a new RNA strand in 5' to 3' direction, that is, it adds RNA nucleotides to the 3' end of the strand. RNA polymerase also guides the nucleotide into position, facilitates the attachment and elongation. It also has intrinsic proofreading and replacement capabilities and termination recognition capacity. Bacteria and archaebacteria have only one type of RNA polymerase which transcribe all types of RNA, while eukaryotes have multiple types of RNA polymerase, each responsible for synthesis of a distinct subset of RNA. RNA polymerase 1 synthesizes pre-rRNA, which matures and forms the major RNA sections of the ribosomes. RNA polymerase 2 synthesizes precursor of mRNAs and most of the snRNA and microRNA. RNA polymerase 3 synthesizes tRNA. RNA polymerase 4 and 5 found in plants and they are less understood, they make siRNA. It was Roger D. Kornbluth created detailed molecular image of RNA polymerase and awarded Nobel Prize in the year 2006. In prokaryotes, the core of RNA polymerase consists of 5 subunits, like 2 subunits of alpha, 1 beta, 1 beta dash, and 1 omega subunit. A sigma factor binds to the core enzyme, forming a holoenzyme. Sigma factor is responsible for initiation of transcription. After transcription starts, the factor can unbind and let the core enzyme proceed with its work. Eukaryotic and archaeal RNA polymerase also have a similar core structure and work in a similar manner, although they have many extra subunits. All RNA polymerase contain metal cofactors like zinc and magnesium cations, which assist in the transcription process. DNA template. The template strand is the one which is transcribed to give rise to mRNA. The mRNA produced during the transcription has complementary sequences to the template strand. The template strand is also called non-coding strand. It is in 3' to 5' polarity. The opposite DNA strand has the same sequence as that of the mRNA. Since codons are present in mRNA, the DNA strand having the same sequence of mRNA is called coding strand. It is in 5' to 3' polarity. Transcription unit. It is the sequence of nucleotides in DNA that codes for a single RNA molecule along with sequence necessary for its transcription. It normally contains a transcription initiation site, a promoter, structural gene or RNA coding sequences, and a terminator. The site on the DNA from which the first RNA nucleotide is transcribed is called plus one site. Nucleotides that are present before this plus one site are given negative numbers and said to be upstream, while the nucleotides that come after the plus one site are marked with positive numbers and said to be downstream portion. Promoters are certain specific areas on the DNA that act as starting signal for initiation process. In human beings, about 10^5 transcription initiation sites are present on the entire DNA. Promoter is the site for attachment of RNA polymerase enzyme. In case of bacteria, one of the promoter sequence is present at about 35 base pairs upstream of the transcription start site. There is a conserved sequences of TT, GA, CA, and another promoter sequence is present at about 10 base pairs upstream of the transcription start site. It consists of conserved sequences of TA, TA, AT. This is called Prigno box. In case of eukaryotes, the promoter sequence is called Hockness box. It is located at 25 to 30 base pair upstream of the transcription start site. It consists of conserved sequences of TA, TA, AAA. Further upstream, between 70 to 80 base pair, there is another sequence GGCCAATCT called CATBOX. Structural gene. It is a gene that codes for any RNA or protein product. In prokaryotes, structural gene of related function are located adjacent to one another, forming an operon. In eukaryotes, structural gene is composed of coding exons and non-coding introns. Terminator sequence. It is the nucleotide sequence in DNA which marks the end of gene during transcription. This sequence provides signals that trigger the release of mRNA from the transcription complex. Transcription factors. It is the protein that control the rate of transcription of genetic information from DNA to mRNA by binding to a specific DNA sequences. Its main function is to regulate, that is, turn on and turn off the genes in order to make sure that they are expressed in the right cell at right time and in right amount throughout the life of the cell and the organism. There are about 1,600 transcription factors in the human genome. Ribonucleotides. They are the basic building blocks of RNA strand. Four types of ribonucleotides like adenosine monophosphate, guanosine monophosphate, cytidine monophosphate, and uridine monophosphate are present in the cell. Mechanism of transcription. Initiation. Before transcription can take place, the DNA double helix must unwind near the gene that is getting transcribed. To begin transcribing a gene, RNA polymerase binds to the DNA at a region called promoter. Basically, the promoter tells the polymerase where to sit down on the DNA and begin transcribing. The sigma factor of RNA polymerase search the promoter. Once the RNA polymerase has bound to the promoter, it can open up the DNA. DNA opening occurs at the minus 10 element, where the strands are easy to separate due to many adenine and thymine bases. This forms a transcription bubble. When RNA polymerase enzyme reaches the appropriate site, that is plus one site on the gene, the first nucleotide of the mRNA attaches to the initiation site or plus one site on the beta subunit of RNA polymerase. This becomes the 5 prime end of the mRNA. It will be complementary to the bases present in the DNA at plus one site. At this moment, sigma factor is released out. Elongation. During elongation, the RNA polymerase moves along the DNA template. For each nucleotide in the template, RNA polymerase adds a complementary RNA nucleotide to the 3' end of the RNA strand. During formation of new RNA strand, base pairing rule is strictly followed. Thus, adenine in the DNA is transcribed to uracil in mRNA, thymine to adenine, guanine to cytosine, and cytosine to guanine. As the RNA polymerase moves on the DNA template, the DNA helix unwinds downstream and rewinds at the upstream area. RNA polymerase has no nuclease activity, so there is no proofreading. Hence, fidelity is less. Mistake rate in mRNA transcription is 10 raised to 4 or 10 raised to 5 times more than DNA replication. But these mistakes are not inheritable. Termination. RNA polymerase will keep transcribing until it gets the stop signal. The specific signals are recognized by a terminator protein called rho factor. When it attaches to the DNA, the RNA polymerase cannot move further. So, enzyme dissociate from the DNA and consequently, newly formed RNA is released. The RNA released in the above step is ready to be used in translation in case of bacteria. In fact, they are ready little sooner than that. Translation may start while transcription is still going on. Hence, in prokaryotes, transcription and translation are called coupled reactions. But in eukaryotes, the RNA strand released is called premature RNA or hnRNA. It is not yet ready to undergo translation. It has to undergo extensive editing before used in translation process. Therefore, RNA need to undergo through a series of processing called post-transcriptional modifications. Post-transcriptional modifications. It is a set of biological process common to most eukaryotic cells by which the RNA primary transcript is chemically altered to produce a mature functional RNA molecule that can leave the nucleus and perform varieties of different functions in the cell. This process includes three major steps that significantly modify the chemical structure of the RNA molecule. 5' capping. It involves the addition of 7-methyl guanosine triphosphate to the 5' end. The cap protects the 5' end of the primary RNA transcript from attack by ribonucleases. The cap is also useful in recognition of mRNA by the translating machinery. This process is done inside the nucleus. 3' tailing. The pre-mRNA processing at the 3' end of the RNA molecule involves cleavage of its 3' end and then addition of about 250 adenine residues to form a poly A tail in the nucleoplasm. This tail protects the mRNA from attack of 3' exonucleases. Splicing. In this process, introns of RNA that do not code for any protein are removed from the pre-mRNA and the remaining exons, that is, coding sequences, are connected to reform a single continuous molecule. The splicing reaction is catalyzed by a large protein complex called spliceosomes. Assembled from proteins and small nuclear RNA molecules that recognizes splice site in the pre-mRNA. This processing is also done in the nucleus. So to conclude, transcription is highly complex series of events in a gene expression that involves the interaction of numerous proteins and DNA to result in an mRNA strand that can be translated into a protein.